moment on. You for me, dear, only two for tea, dear, from this moment on. From this happy day, no more blue stars, only hoop-de-doo stars, from this moment on. Boy, you got the love I need so much, got the skin I love to touch, got the arms to hold me tight, got the sweet lips to kiss me goodnight. From this moment on, you and I, babe, will be riding high, babe, every care is gone. From this moment on, you got the love, baby, you got my love. From this moment on, you and I, babe, will be riding high, babe, every care is gone. From
Hollywood, the Judy Garland Show, with tonight's guest, Zina Bethune, special guest, Vic Damone, and Judy's guest for tea, George Jessel, brought to you by Dual Filter Terrazin Cigarettes, the famous dual filter with activated charcoal, brings through the great taste of Terrazin's fine tobacco.
Once again, welcome you. And for those of you who didn't read your TV listings this week, we got a lively fella whose voice is mellow, and lovely Zina, our ballerina. I'd like to bid them welcome to my show. Vic Damone and Zina Bethune.
Judy, this really is a thrill.
Be my guest, be my guest.
We're so delighted to be on the bill.
Go on, just be my guest, be my guest.
But may we mention with restraint, we have a slight complaint.
Oh, come on, a complaint already? You're jesting.
They told us on your show that you'd listen to our tales of woe.
Whoops, trapped again. Well, all right, you're my guest. What are your complaints?
Well, because I play the part of a nurse on the nurses, everybody thinks I'm really a nurse. They do.
Yeah?
Well, people stop me on the street, and they tell me they've got a headache or a pain in the back, you know, everything.
People can be so naive.
I know.
That's hard to believe. It really is.
Yeah.
Incidentally, Zina.
Yeah?
I got a pain right here. Oh, I really have in my appendix. It goes right across the chest.
That's your heart, Vic. That's your heart.
Of course
your
it is.
Your appendix is down here.
It is. How do you like that? I had my heart taken out when I was 12.
See, even Vic, you know, the worst of all this, there's a very nice little old gentleman that lives next door to me in New York, and every time something's wrong, he comes to me with a headache or a pain in his back.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Well, no, it certainly is. He's a doctor.
I tell you, I know just what you're going through. Years ago, I recorded some Italian songs, you see. And ever since then, people think I'm really Italian. I'm ready to change back to my real name.
What's that?
You really want to know?
Yeah.
Vito Farinola.
You're Vito Farinola.
That's right.
I'm Francis Gum.
How are you?
I'm Zina Bethune.
Gesundheit.
Gesundheit, yes.
Is that your real name? What's your real name, Zina, really?
Well, that's it. Who would change their name to Zina Bethune?
Okay, well, any other complaints? Or
complexes.
No, everybody on the show's been very nice to me.
Really?
You know, especially the man in charge of wardrobe. He's been with me every night this week, trying on dresses till I found the one I like.
Yeah.
And Judy, may I thank him publicly?
Of course, be my guest. Go right ahead.
Vic, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Listen, I have something for you. I think you're
going to
like.
You have? Oh, I'd love it. I'll see you later. I'll see you later.
Well, I get guest stars, and when I get them, I've got to let them do what they want to do. By the way, the same thing goes for you and you and you. You're the people I want to invite. Won't you join in? There's a party tonight. Why don't you really relax and be my
friend.
people are most surprising. We think of Fred McMurray as only an actor. Actually, he started his career as a saxophone player, and Phil Silvers is a great comedian, as you all know. He's also an excellent clarinet player. And you take our lovely guest star tonight, Zina Bethune. She started her career. We think of her always as Gail Lucas on The Nurses every week, right? But she started originally as a dancer, and a very, very fine one she is, too. Miss Zina Bethune. That's marvelous. They just loved you. That was terrific.
Well, thank you. I just hope I pleased my severest critic.
Who?
My mother.
Oh. Well, your mother must be very proud of you, seeing you all every week on The Nurses. Didn't she love it?
Well, no, not really. My mother always wanted me to be a doctor.
Oh. You know, and you dance beautifully.
Thank you.
And you've got a lovely sense of humor. As a matter of fact, you're a delightful guest.
Well, you know, it's fun doing a musical for a change. You know what, like I told you before, people always think I'm really a nurse.
Yeah.
Well, it's a big problem.
I know. I know what you go through. A friend of mine who's a big star on television, has that. They think he's the fellow that he portrays on television every week, and he's not.
Well, who's that?
Harry Walker.
Harry Walker, who's he?
He's the fellow that plays the part of Ed Sullivan.
Oh, really?
And you have no idea how many people think I'm the real Judy Garland.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Now, if you got any sense at all, who'd be her? I wouldn't be. If I were her, I wouldn't be her.
No, I guess so.
Listen, when you play a dramatic role, actually, the people don't get to know the real you, do they?
No, not really. But, you know, I could clue you in a little bit right now.
What? Tell me.
Well, I'm 5'4". I weigh 106 pounds.
Getting to know you. Getting to know all about you.
I paint, sculpt, crochet. I love to cook, but I'm a bad eater, luckily.
Getting to like you. Getting to hope you like me.
Oh, I do. You know I do. Hey, by the way, have you got a recipe for meatloaf? I've got a very good one. You know, you just put a little tomato on the side.
Yeah, hard-boiled egg right in the middle of the house.
Hey, that's pretty good. I haven't even tried that.
Getting to know you. Putting it my way, but nicely. You are precisely my cup of tea.
Oh, tea. You know, I love tea, especially with meatloaf. But, you know, I can't drink coffee at night. It keeps
me awake. I can't
either. Away.
One cup of coffee, I stay awake all night.
Hey, do you know what's very good? Before you go to bed, from the nurse. Yeah, a cup of warm milk.
Yes, that's very good. Very good. A little honey in it is nice. Try a little honey, warm milk and honey.
Well, no, I drink cream in my tea and honey, and it just doesn't mix. It's too sweet.
I don't like warm milk at all. I think it's awful.
Getting to know you, getting to feel
free. I think it's the most miserable
easy.
Drink, a little warm milk.
Maybe so.
I can't take it without a shot of chocolate in it.
Getting to know you, getting to know what to
say. Say, do you have trouble saying it? Saying the
we
wrong
did it.
Thing.
We broke each other.
Do you ever have trouble saying the wrong? I do you say the wrong things?
Yeah, I'm forever putting my foot in my mouth.
Me
no,
too.
I am.
I'm always in trouble.
But I'm, you know, I'm not under any pressure talking to you.
No, that's nice, darling.
Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy.
That's good.
Because of all the beautiful and new things I'm learning about you.
Gee, it's been nice talking to you, Frida.
No, Sarah.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was rude of me. I love you on Ben Casey.
And you know, I watch your show every week, and let me tell you, personally, I think you're much better without Desi.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very proud to present the lively one, Vito Farinol.
To know somehow you are near, the overpowering feeling that any second you may suddenly. Let's take an old-fashioned walk. I'm just bursting with talk. What a tale could be told if we went for an old-fashioned walk. Let's take a stroll through the park. down a lane where it's dark. And a heart that's controlled may relax on an old-fashioned walk. I know for a couple who seem to be miles apart. There's nothing like walking and having a heart-to-heart. I know a girl who declined, couldn't make up her mind. She was wrapped up in soul coming home from that old-fashioned walk. Let's take an old-fashioned walk. I'm just bursting with talk. What a tale could be told if we went for an old-fashioned walk. Let's take a stroll through the park, down a lane where it's dark. And a heart that controlled may relax on an old-fashioned walk. I know for a couple who seem to be miles apart, there's nothing like walking and having a heart-to-heart. And a heart-to-heart. I know a girl who declined, couldn't make up her mind. She was wrapped up and sold, coming home from an old-fashioned walk.
Judy Garland Show has been brought to you by the American Tobacco Company on behalf of Juul Filter, Territon Cigarettes. The second half of the Judy Garland Show is brought to you by Head and Shoulders, one dandruff shampoo that really works with just regular use.
Oh, Bess, where is my Bess? Won't somebody tell me where? I ain't care what she say, I ain't care what she done. Won't somebody tell me where's my Bess?
Summertime, and the living is easy. Fish are jumping.
One of these mornings, you're gonna rise up
singing. It ain't necessarily so.
Then you'll spread
your light to read in the Bible.
You take to the sky.
It ain't necessarily so.
But till that morning,
of nothing,
there's a nothing can harm you. There's a boat that's leaving soon for New York. Come with me, that's where we belong. Sister, you and me could live the high life in New York. Come with me, that's where we belong. Sister,
actually the first time that I've had a cup of tea since I was a Marine in the Boxer Rebellion in 1884. But renewing this association with you on your show, considering the fact that I feel like your father confessor, and a lot of people do know it was in my book, so help me, that many years ago I met you. You were a tiny girl in Chicago. Do you remember?
That's right. Yes, I do remember.
My goodness.
You were so nice to me.
Well, I was always nice to attractive young girls and old men, too. But anyway.
I seem like an old man.
No, you seem like a doll. Yeah. We were playing, I think you must remember, at the Oriental Theater in Chicago.
Chicago.
My, how crowded the theater. We were doing 6 shows a day.
That's right.
And I remember you were a baby with your family doing an act. The Gum Sisters.
Yes.
The Gum Sisters.
Terrible name.
Yes, it was a bad name.
And
I was the sort of a big macher, the boss of
the
theater.
You were the star.
And they got rid of a lot of the acts. And not that they were bad, but they got rid of them because we don't need it. You know, Georgie, you talk so much and the people want to see you, which they did then. And
they still do, though.
And one woman in Pittsburgh. And, and anyway, The manager said we're going to go. I said, no, I tell you what you do. I said, you know, as young and full of pep, I'll stay on as long as you like. I said, but keep that little girl. Do you remember that?
Yes, I do.
Keep that little girl. Let the rest of the people go. Not that they're not good, but let them go. And Chicago, of course, was one. Do you remember Chicago then?
I remember Chicago.
You remember what was going on then?
Well, a lot of people were shooting each
other. Oh, shooting each other was nothing.
Wasn't Dillinger killed?
No, Dillinger was long after that.
No, it was that time.
Oh, that was Jesse James that I knew. But seriously, I remember one thing happened while we were playing there. There was a very tough fellow there. And he was a fellow that was, like many of the so-called hooligans, was kind to his mother. And every Friday night, he'd go home where he lived on Maxwell or Summer Street, have dinner with his mama. You know, shoot people in the morning, have dinner, then shoot some more, you know?
Between meals.
Between meals. And finally, this night, on Friday night, he came home in an armored car to see his mother for the usual Friday night dinner. And as he stepped out of the armored car, they shot him, full of holes. Yeah. And breathless and bleeding, he climbed up the stairs and knocked on the mother's door. And she opened it. She said, Morris. He says, Mama, Mama, they got me. She says, first you'll eat, and then you'll tell me all about it. But the cute thing was, do you remember I told your mama, first, you remember I introduced you. You came out alone.
Yes,
little baby girl. And I say to the audience, that's right, Francis Ethel Gum. And it sounded, Eppis, Francis Eppis Gum. And it sounded like some funny little kid, like with pigtails. And the audience used to giggle. And I told your mother, I said, gee, I don't like that name for this lovely, warm little thing. She ought not to have, so she said, Mrs. Jessel, well, she's just starting, you know. Call her anything you like. And, so you don't know this, but what happened was there was a great actress called Judith Aniston, and she was opening in a Broadway show that night. And I had a Filipino valet who dressed me. I'm now addressing him, anyway. And he called down from the balcony, saying, Mr. Jesse, don't forget to send a telegram to Judith Aniston. She opened a new show, and I called from down a very flowery telegram. Dear Judith, may tonight add another rose to the garland of successes that adorn your great to something. And then I walked on, and I said, and now, ladies and gentlemen, a little girl destined to go very far in the show business, Judith Garland. And I said, that's you, honey. Yeah. And she came out.
That's right.
That's underlined.
Tea?
Nah.
No.
This is scenery for me, that's all.
Oh,
but I remember one thing.
Can I have some tea?
Sure, have some if you like.
Straight here.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'll have some with you.
Yeah. Well, you taste it first.
Mmm. This is delicious. With beer, I'd like to have. I said, now, little Miss Garland will sing, and I lifted you up on the piano.
Yes, you did.
First, I set you on my knee, which I would like to do again now. And
okay.
No, set you up on the piano, and you sang a song. I wonder if you remember, because this was a song that should have been sung by a woman who was with a broken heart, and a woman much more matured. And here were you, little Judy, 10, I think you were, and you sang the song. Do you remember the song?
My bell.
Yeah. Sing a few bars of My Bell.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'll make out like I'm putting you on the...
Okay.
All right.
Come on.
Go ahead.
He's just my Bill, an ordinary boy. He hasn't got a thing that I can brag about. And yet to be upon his knee, so comfy and roomy, seems natural to me. Listen, now you sang. You remember
right.
My mother's.
Wasn't that lovely?
Please do.
No, it's you, not me, all right? That's right. I had just introduced the song. I took you off the piano, sent you back to Mama's. Your mama got a new name, and then I said, here's a song of mine, which I did. It was in a movie that
please,
I made.
Would you do for me?
All right, that was this one. One bright and guiding light, That brought me along for the ride. I found in my mother's eyes those baby tales she told, that road all paved with gold. I found in my mother's eyes, just like a wandering sparrow, one lonely soul, I walk the straight and narrow just to reach my goal. God's gift sent from above, that one real unselfish love I found in my mother's
be forgot and never brought to mind. Well, the reason we're singing this song is that we tape our shows in advance. And although tonight's show was scheduled for November the 3rd, it just might wind up on the air New Year's Eve.
Tonight?
Never
yeah.
tell you
tonight.
Oh, dear. No, I had Leo DeRocher come and do a show with me, talk about the forthcoming World Series 2 weeks after the Dodgers won.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, that's true. So to protect ourselves,
that's
tonight,
ridiculous.
We are going to do a sort of an all-purpose holiday medley.
No.
And that way we'll be covered no matter when they decide to show this, right?
Right, right, right.
Okay.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly. La 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 la. La 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly. La 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 la.
La 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 la. La
dong, ding dong, ding dong.
Upon it.
You'll be the grandest ladies in the Easter parade.
Oh, that's lovely. Faith and Flora! And the most important day of the year to people like Flanagan, Fannigan, Milligan, Gilligan, Duffy, McCuffy, Malaki, Mahone.
Rappity, rappity, dolly, collie, doodly, homie, Mahone, Mahone.
Rappity, rappity, dolly, collie, doodly, homie, Mahone, Mahone. Fannigan, 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 Fannigan,
minute.
Bellini.
Why? There aren't that many Irish people.
Irishman.
What about that other great holiday song?
Oh, yeah.
Buongiorno.
Oh, boy. Once I built a railroad, made it run, made it race against time. Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Buddy, can you spare a dime?
What kind of a holiday is that? Well, you broke the whole thing.
Can you spare a dime?
That's income tax.
No, it's income tax.
It's not a holiday.
It's for Uncle Sam, I can tell you that. Oh, Uncle Sam, we forgot his birthday.
Right. Oh, I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. Yankee Doodle do or die. A real live nephew of your Uncle Sam. Born on the 4th of July. You're a grand.
Buongiorno.
Oh, no, here he goes again. How about February 22nd, George Washington's birthday? Oh, good, good. Come on, let's... All right. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, George Washington. Happy birthday to you. Wait a minute. No, we overlooked Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, we didn't.
Thanksgiving. For little girls. For little girls get now, bigger every day.
I know. I have. Me and my shadow.
What holiday is that?
That's Groundhog Day. What about that? The most important holiday of all comes in May. M is for the million things she gave me. O means only that she's growing old. T is for the tears she shed to save me. H is for her heart of purest gold.
Put them all together, they spell more.
That's what we are.
Well, anyway, in case we've left anything out.
In case we stepped on it.
Yeah. Yeah, well, let's get out of it by singing an all season song.
Season's greetings, Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.
Bon voyage and April Fool.
Loads of Easter cheer. Kindest wishes on your birthday. And on March 17th,
won't you be my Valentine?
Happy Halloween.
Have a lovely Arbor Day.
Don't forget Pearl Harbor Day.
Merry May Day. Happy Pay Day.
Have a lovely Labor Day Day. While you're living, Thanksgiving, shine on Harvest Moon. Up your overcoat, except in June. Peace on earth, get out and vote and get well
what old things we can find in here tonight. Oh, what's this? Ah, that's the first sweater I ever knitted. I got so bored sitting around between takes when I used to be in the movies that I took up knitting. That's kind of cute. What else we have? They never gave us any wastebaskets in our restaurant. Oh, this is what was left over from that sweater I knitted. I hit this one. Oh, come on. That's just silly. Terrible things. Oh, this reminds me of something nice. This. We did an imitation of Charlie Chaplin once. And, you know, he's quite an extraordinary gentleman because he not only is a brilliant, brilliant artist as a comedian and actor, but he's a wonderful composer. He's written some lovely songs. And one of my favorite songs that Mr. Chaplin wrote is this one. Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow, you'll see the sun come shining through. If you light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile. Rock-a-bye your baby with a Dixie melody. When you croon a tune from the heart of Dixie, just hang my cradle, mammy mine, right on that Mason-Dixon line, and swing it from Virginia to Tennessee with all the love that's in you. Weep no more, my lady, sing that song again for me. Sing old Black Joe, just as old you had me on your knee. A million baby kisses I'll deliver if you will only play that Swanee River. Rock-a-bye, you rock-a-bye, baby, with a Dixie melody. I'll weep no more, my lady, sing that song again for me. Sing old Black Joe, just as old you had me on your knee. A million baby kisses I'll deliver if you will only play that Swanee River. Rock a bye, you're rock a bye, baby, with a Dixie melody.
When the birds make love to the bees, I will come back. When the sun refuses to shine, and everybody's cousin is a cousin of mine, I will come back. When the fish walk around on 2 feet and promenade up and down on Washington Street,
when the snow has turned from white to blue, then maybe I will come back to you.
The second half of the Judy Garland Show has been brought to you by Zest, the soap with the shampoo lather. Feel shampoo clean all over with Zest.
A method of handling their policyholders is called stark fear. You see, everybody's afraid that if they make a claim on their policy, they're going to lose the policy, so nobody ever makes a claim. It's wild. Like a couple of days ago, a truck went through a red light, turned down a one-way street against traffic, went up over the curb into a parking lot, and hit my parked car. Now, I didn't fool around. I gave the guy $50, told him to forget it. You think I'm going to lose my insurance because of some clumsy truck driver? No, no. No, I don't know. I talk about insecurity, but you see, I'm not that insecure, even at this job, because I have other things that I do for a living. I don't just do this. I had a job not too long ago working as a disc jockey for Connell Red. Which is kind of depressing, you know. You sit there with this one record of a siren waiting for something to happen. Then I worked for a while in Los Angeles area building split-level fallout shelters with screened-in patios for wealthy Christian Scientists. But that didn't seem to meet the need. I believe in underground living, to tell you the truth, because it's handy. Like if somebody dies, you just throw them out the window. What could be handier than that? But you know, of all the jobs that I have had in this business, the one I had most recently is the one I've been asked to tell you about tonight. As those of you who subscribe to the Katanga Picayune already know, the United States, in an effort to create better international relations, made arrangements for the last combined folk and jazz festival to be held in Leopoldville, rather than Newport. As a musician, member of President Kennedy's Peace Corps, I had the pleasure of attending this hootenanny. I'm not in the Peace Corps anymore. I was, because I became so involved emotionally with the underdeveloped country that they sent me to that I was finally arrested one day for leading a mob and throwing rocks at the U.S. Embassy, and they brought me back in chains. It was embarrassing. But I was over there for the festival, you know, for the Hootenanny, and that's the important thing. And I was asked if tonight I would tell you a little bit about the Hootenanny. Those of you, for one reason or another, couldn't make it. First off, there weren't many guest stars. There was one belly dancer doing sort of an out-of-town opening in preparation for a Greenwich Village booking. And he, He wasn't too good, I don't think. Well, he was an unusual belly dancer. He danced on other people's bellies. It was strange. He's underweight, so he never hurt anybody, but it was kind of wild. I had the pleasure of performing several nights at this Hootenanny, and I was asked if tonight I would come here and do something that I did at that festival. Of course, I'm very happy to do this. And so, through the magic of turning my back to you, we take you now to the Leopoldville Hootenanny. Jimmy crack horn, and I don't care, Jimmy crack. Well, without arrangements, it's kind of tough, but most of you probably recognize that tune as being the theme from the movie Gidget Meets King Kong and Goes Ape. And a lot of people don't recognize it as being that. I only mention that because I happen to be in the movie. I played the part of King's younger brother, Shecky Kong. I was a little ape myself in that movie. Say, what do you think of this? Made it myself. Only 3 weeks in that little convalescent hospital in Lexington, Kentucky. It's a wonderful thing down there, wonderful therapy. I'm kind of proud of this because it's made from 100% simulated silk. And as you know, 100% simulated silk is only made by the Japanese simulated silkworm. But I made this thing all by myself, which may give you some insight as to why I spent so much time in that hospital. Worst case of worms they ever saw there. It's really bad. While in Africa, I had the pleasure, and then I had it again last night, which isn't bad for me. I had the pleasure of singing with a folk group called the Brothers Folk Group. And we recorded an album of songs over there that became very big in Tanganyika before I left. It includes such well-known favorites as The Sun Shines Bright on My Old Katanga Home, Nasser's in the cold, cold ground, Old White Joe. Sort of an Uncle Tom song over there. Muhammad Henry was a camel driving man, Lord, Lord. Kind of folky. I's gwine leave old Tuscaloosa. That's actually a Scottish ballad, doesn't belong in this album. Hark, Albert Schweitzer, Schwings, which is the last album of Al Schweitzer, entitled Al Schweitzer Plays and Sings the Selected Poetry of Cassius Clay. A lot of toe-tappers here. Ghana must be heaven, cause my Mau Mau came from there. And a few, but there's one American song that I had the pleasure of singing on Leopoldville's number one television show, Eat the Press. And tonight, in an attempt to get off the stage, I'd like to do this song for you, accompanied on my zither, a little something I picked up at Sears. It's a Kenmore. Bought it on the revolving charge over there. This song from my latest album, Songs I Sing While Doing the Warm-Up for the Ozzie and Harriet Reruns. Here it is. Slowly with feeling, that's the instructions. Where's that song? Oh, here it is. By the way, this is a war song. I didn't tell you about that. I don't know how much you know about war songs, but they're usually written in advance. I better explain that to you. Well, take a song like Over There. Now, Over There was a very big war song. I don't know who wrote Over There, except I'm fairly sure it wasn't written by the enemy because they already happened to be over there at the time, and if they had written it, it probably would have been called Over Here. Oh, boy. But anyway, Over There, if you remember the song, it goes like, over there, send the word, over there, we'll be over, we're coming over. You see, this was written before we went over there. There are certain historians who claim that we weren't even planning on going over there, but then the song became a hit, and we felt obligated, you know. But I don't know if that's true or not, but I do know that if we had decided not to go over there after the song was written, the song would never become the hit that it has been. My song, this is a song that I wrote. It's a war song I wrote back during World War II. It never got the lucky break that over there did. It never became... Thank you. It never became a big, big hit, but I'd like to do it for you. And there's the chorus here that I want you to all sing along, because the sing-along part in the chorus is the only part of my song that ever became popular. And here it is. You're a natural-born commander in a Caesarian sort of way. It's no matter if you sunk your old PT boat in the bay. You can easily afford to buy another one today. And that is why we say, everybody glory, glory, hallelujah. Open up your hearts. That's the chorus, and thank you for the help there. There's the second verse. Oh, I know that you are destined to be president someday. You will lead this country forward in a backward sort of way. And that is why we sing this song to honor you today. Irving Finsterwald of PT 108.
Garland, show number 12, Vic Damone, Street Where You Live, take one. To know somehow you are near, the overpowering feeling that any second you may suddenly. Take an old-fashioned walk. I'm just bursting with talk. What a tale could be told if we went for an old-fashioned walk.
This is the speaker.